Hey, my beautiful circus monkeys. How you doing? Drake here, and, well, I've had a lot of people tell me that they enjoy the way I speak for some reason, and they want to hear more stories, you know. So, I figured I would come at you today and tell you some stories from when I was growing up, and this will shed some light on why I am the way I am today, possibly. Now, I mentioned in some earlier videos that I kind of grew up at the Stockyards, sort of a local flea market that spans some, like, 3 acres, and this wasn't a normal flea market. I have to set the scene for you, set the atmosphere, the ambiance, if you will. Pretend that you're Alice and you have just fell down the rabbit hole, and instead of being in Wonderland, you are in a flea market in Kentucky where anything goes. I believe I've seen a man walking a goat through the Stockyard on a leash as you would a dog. Anywho, let's get into the story. At the Stockyard, between the snack booth and the barn, because they had a snack shop near the barn, very close to the toilets, so as you do, there was a small drainage pipe, a 3-inch drainage pipe with a little shelf of dirt over it, leaving this small drop-off. And the children at the Stockyard would, like, run and jump off of this small mound and do children things. People would occasionally step off and stumble. Well, one hot summer's day, let's just say this was a very voluminous, elderly woman. She was walking along and stepped off of this, and for whatever reason, she falls. And I don't mean she stumbles and falls over. No, this large old woman face planted right on the ground, scorpion, and didn't move. And it being the Stockyard, immediately a crowd of 20 to 30 onlookers gather around her and they're staring at her like this. I expected someone to poke her with a stick at any moment. Well, the amusement wore off after about 20 seconds when everyone realized that she wasn't moving. At which point some man yelled an expletive which caught everyone's attention and snapped them out of their entertainment, I suppose, and someone called 911 and an ambulance came and had to force its way through the throng of people and picked her up and took her to the hospital. It turns out this overweight older woman had a stroke. She had fallen on her face and had a stroke, but she survived. She was fine, except for the fact that she attempted to sue the owner of the flea market. And in response, I won't mention his name, in response, the owner of the Stockyard built a 4-foot-tall, 6-foot-wide wooden wall in front of the drop-off and proceeded to plaster it with all sorts of warning signs and labels, very much over the top. But this isn't the end of the story. You see, at the Stockyard, anything interesting that happened would become the talk of the town for the rest of the day, at least until the next weekend, the next Saturday, when something else would occupy everyone's minds. So, for the rest of the day at the Stockyard, someone would walk up to a vendor's table and say the following. "Hey, you see that old fat woman fall down?" To which the vendor would reply, I've been here at my table all day. You know, I didn't see it. I wasn't there. Did you see it?" "Yeah, she fell right down on her face." At which point someone else would come over and go, "You guys talking about that old fat woman fall down?" This is all I heard all day. Like, all over the Stockyard, people would, like, come in from town. Somehow, like, people had already called. This was in the day before cell phones. People had, like, called their cousins and their aunts and their uncles and their dogs and said, "Hey, you gotta come down to the Stockyard. Some old fat woman just fell down." I mean, easily amused people make for very amusing situations, I guess. So, that is the story, ladies and gentlemen, of the time at the stockyard when the fat lady didn't sing, but she did fall flat on her face. If you want more stories, don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell and leave your comments down below. I'll get back to you soon with another story. So until then, my beautiful circus monkeys, I bid you a fond adieu.